Joining me now is Rémi Canton from France's National Centre for Space Studies. He's been the project manager for the Alpha mission, just completed by Pesquet and the rest of the team. Thanks so much for coming in and talking to
us. Thanks for having me.
I mean, Thomas Pesquet, we saw those images there, back on Earth at last after an incredible mission. What does it mean for you and for him, do you think, to this moment, to see him finally back on Earth after so much success?
Well, it was an incredible ride, quite literally, for this, for his return to Earth, but for his six-month mission as well. And it's a lot of pride for me personally, but more importantly for the team that built his mission. Some relief for him. So we are proud of what he did, for the work he did, the way he conducted, even as an ambassador, his mission, communicated about it. He advanced science pretty well, and all our experiments, our payloads that we prepared for him, went up there successfully. He operated them successfully, and they will continue after him.
I was going to say, it's not the end, is it? I mean, there's so much more work that now needs to be done, presumably to analyse everything that's been found out during
exactly.
the trip.
Exactly, and by the same token, the science time is much longer than the mission time of a single astronaut. So the payloads are going to stay on the station and be pursued by other astronauts besides him. And for the data related to him, they're going to be analyzed. And actually, in the few coming days, some health monitoring and some science data is going to be recovered as well to compare them against what they were before his flight, to compare before the flight, during the flight, its evolution, and how it returns back to normal.
And I mentioned that tweet that he sent just before he landed there about what next the moon. I mean, it's not the end for him, certainly, is it?
No, of course, he's not hiding his ambition. And he crossed all the odd boxes to qualify for this ideal goal. He had two long-term missions, two successful missions. He was a commander, as you mentioned earlier, of the space station. He performed six extravehicular activities, six EVAs, which is the record time for European astronauts, so almost 40 hours. So he's not alone. There's another German astronaut, another Italian astronaut who had the same kind of profile missions. But he's certainly in the game. And then in terms of a geopolitical interest, we'll see what's going to happen.
It's all about diplomacy, isn't it?
Exactly.
I suppose. Yeah, yeah. And what happens to him now? I mean, as you mentioned, there's a couple of weeks, isn't there, where he needs to be kind of physically retrained.
Yes.
And then what?
Well, first of all, he's back in the US on solid ground for now. He's going to fly back to Europe today and landing in Cologne at the European Astronaut Center tonight. Then 3 weeks of, like we said, of health monitoring. Then after, he is a European Space Agency employee, so ESA will tell him what to do. He's a pilot. He's among his tasks is piloting the zero-G aircraft in a Novespace in Bordeaux. And then, hopefully, if he is assigned to another mission, he's going to train for that. But it's not going to be for tomorrow. We're going to wait a few months or years.
What do you think this has meant for France? Because, I mean, it's been a massive story here in France, perhaps not so much in other countries, but just, you know, seeing him there, being able to do that, how much of an encouragement do you think that is to younger people as well who may be watching?
It's incredible. We, on top of the scientific experiments we had for him, we had also educational activities, and they worked very, very well. It's called Blob. And 4,500 schools did the same experiment on the ground that he did in space. It's about 100,000 students or pupils. And with all these, his ability to communicate in an understandable fashion, he really managed through all the age groups to give interest in science, in what he does, not just the pictures, nice pictures he's taking, but in the work he's doing to promote science, to advance science. So yes, he's the best ambassador we can dream of.
And it's that energy that he has as well, isn't it? I mean, not just to do that, but I mean, in space, but all the other things that he does as well around and
surrounding. Yeah, exactly. He's an all-around guy, and his professionalism for his main task, then the communication abilities, the sense of humor he has, so the
Yeah, I mean, we were laughing about the headline that I'd written
exactly.
Using the word superhero, but it kind of applies to him, doesn't it?
Yeah, certainly, and he probably doesn't believe he is, which is good, but but yeah, seen from outside, he kind of is.
Rémi Canton, thanks very much for coming in and talking to us
Thanks
today,
for having me.
For joining us from France's National Centre for Space Studies. Thanks.
Thank you.